The science podcast that describes an interesting aspect of science in 5 minutes or less. I am Julia.
And I am Luke. We are the guest podcasters for this episode. Today we will be explaining the science behind time zones. We will be looking at what they are and how they work. So Julia, what exactly are time zones?
Well, Luke, time zones are defined as the local time of a specific region. For example, our local time in Winnipeg is not the same as the local time in Paris, France. Time zones are determined by the difference from UTC. This stands for Coordinated Universal Time. UTC is situated in Greenwich, England, which is where the prime meridian lays. Here in Winnipeg, our time zone is UTC minus 6. This means that we are 6 hours behind UTC, and this has to do with our longitude in relation to the prime meridian.
Which brings us to how time zones work. In order to understand the science behind time zones, you have to understand how the Earth rotates. To start, the Earth rotates on an imaginary axis angled at 23.5 degrees. Every 24 hours, the Earth will complete one full rotation around this axis, which is what results in day and night. For example, imagine shining a flashlight on half of a globe. The part illuminated by the flashlight is experiencing day, while the other side is in darkness. As the Earth rotates, each part of the world will receive day and night. There are 24 geographic time zones in the world, each separated by 15 degrees of longitude. However, these are not always strictly followed worldwide. Some countries that are trading partners choose to stay in the same time zone, even though geographically one should be an hour apart. This makes trade a lot easier, especially when it comes to scheduling meetings. And another reason why some countries do not follow time zones perfectly is because of daylight savings time.
A main reason as to why we have time zones is so there is a worldwide consistency of what is considered day and night. Daylight savings time is used by approximately 40% of the world, and its purpose is to conserve daylight in the evening. During the fall seasons, places will set their clocks back an hour, and then during the spring season, the clocks will adjust forward an hour.
You know what they say, Julia, fall back, spring forward.
That's right, Luke.
While daylight savings time isn't used consistently around the world, there are some cases where it isn't even used consistently in one country. For example, here in Canada, the province of Saskatchewan ignores daylight savings time completely. Saskatchewan is a hub for farming in Canada. A reason why they don't follow daylight savings time is because of the schedule they follow to milk their cows. If this schedule was to suddenly change because of daylight savings time, the cows wouldn't like it and would produce less milk. And even more extreme cases would be British Columbia, where only parts of the province follows daylight savings time. In 2015, there was a public vote in the area of Fort Nelson, British Columbia, to determine whether or not they would follow daylight savings time. The public voted against daylight savings time, which is why they don't follow it. There are many arguments for and against daylight savings time.
Yes, there are. The original purpose of daylight savings time was to conserve the amount of energy used in the evenings. Because with daylight savings time in use, there would be an increase in sunlight, so less energy would be required. This idea was proposed by George Hudson from New Zealand. But it is important to understand that changing our clocks by an hour won't physically create more sunlight, but it is rather an illusion by our human behaviors. For example, when we go to bed and when we wake up. However, many would say that this is not a good enough reason to set our clocks forward or back an hour. On the other hand, a magazine called Rescue Time says that there is an estimated $480 million lost in productivity the week after daylight savings time. A reason for this is because of the 1 hour of sleep that is lost. This shows that just 60 minutes of sleep can make a big difference in productivity. There are many bills put forth annually all around the world to abolish daylight savings time, but because of these varying opinions, nothing seems to change.
And speaking of time, we seem to have ran out of time for this episode. Thanks for listening to All This Science. Once again, I'm Luke.
And I'm Julia. Contact us at allthisscience@gmail.com if you'd like.
Bye.